And that's a wonderful thing. So I just want to greet all of God's people here tonight. Because when I come here, he was when he come to my church and I brought it. As if I am in charge.
Yes. Yes.
So when I come here, I come home. So nobody stop me from talk. Amen. Amen. But when he comes here, he trample all over and enjoy. When we come back, we come home. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Go ahead, Sheila. Quickly to Genesis chapter 47. I'm not going to read from the first verse. I'm just going to read from verse 5. Genesis 47. And Pharaoh spake unto Joseph, saying, thy father and thy brethren are come unto thee. The land of Egypt is before thee. In the best of the land make thy father and brethren to dwell. In the land of Goshen, let them dwell. And if thou knowest any men of activities among them, then make them ruler over my cattle. And Joseph brought in Jacob, his father, and set him before Pharaoh. And Jacob blessed Pharaoh. And Pharaoh said unto Jacob, how old art thou? And Jacob said unto Pharaoh, the days of the years of my pilgrimage, or 130 years. Few and evil have the days of the years of my life been, and I have not attained unto the days of the year, the life of my father, in the days of the pilgrimage. And Jacob blessed Pharaoh and went out from before Pharaoh. Father, we thank you, we adore you, magnify you, lift up your name on high. We give you praise, God, because you are God and there is none like unto you, who was and who shall ever be. And we say thanks in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise God.
Tonight I just want to talk to you briefly. So if I did not preach tonight, don't worry. But I want to talk to you briefly, gentlemen. If you look and see what God did, Joseph was a man who went through trials, went through tribulation, who was looked on in some belittling way. But something was important about the man. Although his brothers, his brethren, seemed to have a grudge on him, they could not stop him. There was a robe of many colors that was given to him by his father. And even that they grudge him for. I don't think these two gentlemen have just come up and get pastoring just like that. I believe there were hard times and rough time and painful time and troublesome time. But when you decide to hold on to God's unchanging hand, no matter how the road may become rough, and the going get tough, and the hills are hard to climb, oh shekel of a son, you only have to hold on to the hands of God. But one thing I understand and one thing I know, I want to be proven, that when God gets ready, no matter what the battles are, they have to come down.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Maybe, just maybe, when you came here, some people might not have felt that you should. I said maybe. Maybe somebody has felt I was around before you. Don't go and trouble nobody. But if I do that, God, I'm doing. So you came as a humble man, and you found another man who you chose to be your assistant. I listened carefully. Don't think to get your take away my hearing. I listened carefully and I heard what sister said. When the suspense drove out of the journey, said not a word. But while he was not speaking physically from his lips, he was speaking with his tears. For tears became his language.
Yes.
Oh, help me, Jesus. We need some crying Christians.
Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus.
Some Christians who will understand the hardships. Some Christians who will lay down on the altar. Some Christians who will understand the pain the pastor has to go through. The hardships and the trials, praise the name of the Lord. Some Christians have to understand that sometimes they're thrown in the pit.
Yes. Oh, yes.
Lord, some people do, pastor, when you're down in the pit, they come and look down on you.
Okay, my Jesus. My God, Lord.
And some Christian will tell you, making bread, eating that easy though, yeah. Excuse the term, I could say here. Others have come better than you and couldn't do it. If they're not sinning, they're not better than you. And the reason why some could manage and would never manage, when you're sent by God, no matter what is in the way, when you're sent by God upon the authority of the Holy Ghost, you're going to break down barrier through the blood of Jesus Christ. Glory to the name of Jesus. It takes the blood.
Yes. Praise God.
Glory.
Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah. It won't take your manship. You take the blood of Jesus Christ. When you can get down on your knees and pray, as though you started on a hard ground, tough ground, yet still God is making a way for you. Joseph had a quote.